Hello everyone, this is Azra Sultana, Assistant Professor in Degree Department, working in ISL Engineering College. So last class we have seen analysis of grid circuit with overlap, and previous classes we have seen analysis of grid circuit without overlap. Okay, so in today's class we are going to see about the LCC bridge characteristics. LCC is nothing but line commutated converter. So we are going to see the characteristics of line commutated converter. So previously what we have seen the converter circuits for both line commutated and voltage source converters. So Graves bridge is the basic building block in LCC and also in VSC based HVDC converters, that is for multi-pulse converters. So in 12 pulse LCC, two Graves bridges are connected in series on the DC side and in parallel on the AC side. 12 pulse LCC is fed by three single phase transformers, each with three windings. One will be primary and two will be secondary. One set of secondary windings connected in star will feed one bridge, while the other set of secondary windings connected in delta will feed the second bridge. Okay, this we have already seen in the previous classes. So previous class we have seen there will be three modes, that is mode 1, mode 2, mode 3. When we analyze line commutated converter, we have seen the timing diagram also. So for mode 1, U is less than 60 degrees, 2 and 3 valve conduction will take place. Mode 2, 3 valve conduction, that is U is equal to 60 degrees. And mode 3, 3 and 4 valve conduction and U is greater than 60 degrees. And we have seen analysis of 2 and 3 valve conduction mode, first one. And second one, we have seen analysis of 3 and 4 valve conduction mode. So various voltage equations and characteristics we have seen for these two modes. Okay. So in today's class, we are going to see about the LCC bridge characteristics, that is for rectifier and for inverter, both we are going to see. So let us start with rectifier. So rectifier in general will have three modes of operation. First mode, 2 and 3 valve conduction mode, that is U is less than 60 degrees. U or mu, anything is same, students. Okay. First mode is 2 and 3 valve conduction mode, that is U is less than 60 degrees. Second mode will be 3 valve conduction mode. That is only for alpha less than 30 degrees. At that time, U is equal to 60 degrees. And third mode is 3 and 4 valve conduction mode. Alpha is greater than equal to 30 degrees. And U lies between 60 and 120 degrees. So these are the three modes of operation of a rectifier. As the DC current continues to increase, converter operation will change over from mode 1 to 2 and finally it will move to mode 3. The DC voltage continues to decrease until it reaches 0. For alpha greater than or equal to 30 degrees, mode 2 is bypassed. For modes 1 and 3, we can have the equation as Vd by Vd0 is cos alpha, that is Id divided by 2Is. And Vd by Vd0 is root 3 cos alpha minus 30 degrees minus 3 Id by 2Is. Voltage and current characteristics are linear in these two cases, but with the different slopes. For mode 2, U equal to 60 degrees, U is constant, characteristics are elliptical, and the equation is given by Vd dash by cos mu by 2 square plus Id dash by sin mu by 2 square equal to 1. So here mu can be replaced by U. Okay, students, where Vd dash is equal to Vd by Vd0 and Id dash is Id by 2Is. So from this equation we can write the equation for Vd dash and Id dash. Vd dash is 1 by 2 cos alpha plus cos of alpha plus U, that is cos alpha plus U by 2 cos U by 2. Id will be half cos alpha minus cos alpha plus U, that is sin alpha plus U by 2 sin U by 2. So the quantity for rectifier operation is shown in the figure. and this is a converted VDID characteristics. So x-axis we have taken ID by 2IS and y-axis VD by VD0. So coordinates of the points A, B, C, D and E on the boundary will be given in this tabular column. See here, this is a boundary of 55 characteristics. Point E will correspond to the maximum power output of the converter. So these are the values of alpha, U, ID dash and VD dash. And points are A, B, C, D, E. So at A point, that is in this figure you can see, at A, B, C, D, E, okay, what is the value of alpha, what is the value of U or mu, what is the value of ID dash, what is the value of VD dash. For A, at point A, alpha is 0, U is 0, ID dash is 0, VD dash is 1.0. At B, alpha is 0, U is 60 degrees, ID dash is 0.25, VD dash is 0.75. At C, alpha is 30 degrees, U is 60 degrees, ID dash is 0.3/4, VD dash is also same. And at D, alpha is 30 degrees, U is 120, ID is 1/√3, VD is 0. At E, alpha is 15 degrees, U is 60 degrees, ID dash is 1/√2, VD dash is √3/2√3. Now let us see inverter characteristics. Inverter characteristics are similar to the rectifier characteristics. However, the operation as an inverter will require minimum commutation margin. Minimum commutation margin angle during which the voltage will cross the valve is negative. So operating region of an inverter will be different from that of a rectifier. Commutation margin angle zeta. See here, symbol is zeta here. So this commutation margin angle zeta is equal to the extinction angle gamma. Okay, extinction angle is denoted by gamma. Commutation margin angle is denoted by zeta. So commutation margin angle is equal to the extinction angle only for values of beta is less than or equal to 60 degrees. So from the figure, A figure, there are three figures here, A, B and C, first range, second range and third range. So from the first figure, we can say that the voltage across the valve has a positive dent T because of the succeeding commutation. This dent will normally occur at beta less than or equal to 60 degrees after the sinusoidal voltage on which it is superposed has become positive. So hence under this condition, zeta is equal to gamma. With increased overlap and consequently earlier ignition of the valve, dent will approach on the period in which the valve voltage will otherwise be negative, and this will make zeta is less than gamma. After the front of the dent becomes entirely negative, further advance of the dent does not decrease commutation margin further. Okay. So margin angle zeta has different relationship to gamma depending on the range of operation. So there are three ranges, first range, second range and third range. So in the first range, what we are telling here, commutation margin angle zeta is equal to extinction angle. Voltage across the valve will have a positive dent D. Okay, here this is positive dent D. Because of the succeeding commutation, this dent will occur at beta is less than 60 degrees, less than or equal to 60 degrees. After the sinusoidal voltage has become positive, okay. So zeta is equal to gamma for this case, for first range. With increased overlap and consequently earlier ignition or firing of the valve, dent encroaches on the period in which the valve voltage will otherwise be negative. That is for B, that is for second range we are telling this one. So here in second range we can say that the valve voltage has become negative and this will make zeta is less than gamma. Earlier zeta was equal to gamma. In second range, zeta is less than gamma. So after the front of the dent will become entirely negative, further advance of the dent will not decrease commutation margin further. So margin angle zeta has different relationship to gamma depending on the range of operation. So this is the diagram showing the relationship between inverter angles. So margin angle zeta has different relationship to gamma depending on the range of operation, which we are going to see it now. That is, for first range, beta is less than or equal to 60 degrees, zeta is equal to gamma at that time. In second range, beta will lie between 60 and 90 degrees, and zeta is 60 degrees minus u, or gamma minus beta minus 60 degrees. Third range, beta is greater than 90 degrees, or zeta equal to gamma minus 30 degrees. In inverter operation, it is necessary to maintain a certain minimum margin angle zeta naught. This will result in three submodes of the first mode. Overall inverter characteristics can be described as mode 1 and mode 2. So let us first start with mode 1. So for mode 1, beta is less than 60 degrees for values of u less than 60 degrees minus zeta naught, and gamma is gamma naught, that is zeta naught. Characteristics will be linear, and it is defined by Vd is equal to cos gamma naught minus Id. Or we can say it as Vd dash is equal to cos gamma naught minus Id dash. This is first one A bit. Then first one B bit, beta lies this bit between 60 and 90 degrees. For u equal to 60 degrees minus zeta naught, that is 60 degrees minus gamma naught, which is constant. So characteristics is elliptical. For beta is lying between 90 and 90 plus zeta naught, for values of u in the range, u is lying between 60 degrees minus zeta naught and 60 degrees. Characteristics will be linear, and the voltage is defined as Vd dash is equal to cos of gamma naught plus 30 degrees minus Id dash. Mode 2. For u is greater than 60 degrees corresponding to beta greater than 90 degrees plus gamma naught. Characteristics are again linear but with a different slope. And it is divided by voltage equation Vd dash is equal to root 3 cos gamma naught minus 3 Id dash. Boundary of the inverter operation for a value of zeta naught is 15 degrees. And the coordinates of the points A, B, C, D and F on the boundary are given in the following table. Hey students, in this table we can see the boundary of inverter characteristics. Points small a, B, C, D, F, D, E are given here, and top you can see gamma, U and Id dash and Vd dash. So for A point, gamma is 15 degrees, U is 0, Id dash is 0, Vd dash is minus 0.966. B, gamma is 15 degrees, U is 45 degrees, Id is 0.233, voltage is minus 0.0733. For C point, 45 degrees, gamma, U is 45 degrees, current 0.354, voltage minus 0.354. For F, gamma is minus 45 degrees, U is 60 degrees, Id is 0.483, Vd is minus 0.224. For D point, gamma is 45 degrees, U is 90 degrees, Id dash is 0.558, Vd dash is 0. For E, gamma is 22.5 degrees, U is 45 degrees, Id dash is 0.271, Vd dash is minus 0.654. Let us see the numericals. Okay, I hope this is clear to everyone, mode 1 and mode 2. Mode 1, we are taking three conditions, A, B and C. A condition, beta is less than 60 degrees. B condition, beta lies between 60 and 90 degrees. C condition is beta is lying between 90 and 90 plus zeta naught. So what are the various values of voltage and what is the characteristics we have seen for mode 1. Similarly, mode 2 we are taking that U is greater than 60 degrees and beta is greater than 90 plus gamma naught. Characteristics is again linear and voltage equation we have seen. Okay, and we have seen the boundary of inverter characteristics. Now let us see the numerical. A grade bridge operates with a delay angle of 15 degrees. Leakage reactance of the transformer is 10 ohms. Line to line AC voltage is 75 kV. Compute the overlap angle and DC voltage for ID equal to 2000 amps and ID equal to 4500 amps. So two bits are there here for ID equal to 2000 amps. We have to find out the overlap angle and DC voltage, and for ID equal to 4500 amps also we have to determine the overlap angle and DC voltage. Now let us see the solution. A rectifier can operate with U is less than 60 degrees or U equal to 60 degrees or U is greater than 60 degrees. To determine the operating mode, we need to know the boundaries of the first two modes. Boundary or upper limit for ID for mode 1 is given by ID 1 is equal to half of cos alpha minus cos alpha plus 60 degrees. Or ID 1 is equal to IS into cos of alpha value is given as 15 degrees in the question. So substitute the value of alpha as 15 degrees. So we are going to get the value of IS as 6 kilo amps and ID 1 is 4.25 kilo amps. Similarly, upper limit on ID when U equal to 60 degrees is given by ID 2 is equal to IS into cos 30 minus cos 90, that is 5.2 kilo amps. Let us see the first bit, that is when ID is equal to 2000 amps, we have mode 1 with U less than 60 degrees and VD is given as cos alpha minus ID. VD dash is equal to cos alpha minus ID dash, that is cos of 15 minus ID dash also we have found out 2000 by 12,000. So it is 0.8. VD dash is 0.8. VD0 is 3√2 by pi ELL. That is 3√2 into ELL is given as 85 kilovolts. So into 85 by pi. That is 114.8 kilovolts. VD is 0.8. VD0 that is 9. Substitute the value of VD0 as 114.8. Then we are going to get the value of VD as 91.8 kilovolt. Overlap angle is obtained from 2 by 12 is equal to 1 by 2 cos 15 minus cos 15 plus U. So solution here is U is equal to 35.8 degrees. Now let us see second bit, that is when ID is equal to 4500 amps. Mode is U is equal to 60 degrees and ID dash is 4.2 by 12.375 and VD can be formed from the equation VD dash by cos U by 2 whole square plus ID dash by sin U by 2 whole square equal to 1. So VD dash is equal to 1 minus 0.375 by sine 30 degrees square whole power half into cos 30 degrees, that is 0.573, and VD is equal to 0.573 into VD0, that is 65.8 kilovolts. Firing angle is obtained from VD dash is cos alpha minus ID dash. So substitute all the values, VD dash we know 0.573 and ID dash is 0.375. So cos alpha we got it as 0.948. Alpha will be cos inverse of 0.948, that is 18.6 degrees. Let us see next numerical. A 6 pulse inverter is operating at a constant margin angle of 18 degrees. Valve side voltage is 70.7 kilovolt, that is line to line voltage. And the leakage reactance of the converter transformer is 10 ohms. Compute the extinction angle, overlap angle and DC voltage when ID is equal to 2500 amps and ID is equal to 4200 amps. Okay, for two values of ID we have to determine the extinction angle, overlap angle and DC voltage, that is for 2500 amps and for 4200 amps. Let us see the solution. Inverter can operate in either mode 1 or mode 2. For mode 1, U is less than 60 degrees, that is 2 and 3 valve conduction mode, and for mode 2, U is greater than 60 degrees, it is 3 and 4 valve conduction mode. Mode 1 can have 3 sub modes, that is beta is less than 60 degrees, beta lies between 60 and 90 degrees, beta lies between 90 and 90 plus eta naught. To identify the operating mode, it is necessary to know the boundaries of the various modes or submodes. So mode 1, we are assuming here that ID is between 0 and ID 1. So ID 1 is ID IS into cos gamma minus cos beta. IS is root 2 ELL by 2XC. And ELL is given as 70.7 kilovolt. And XC is given as 10 ohms. So substitute these values, we are going to get the value of IS as 5 kilo amps. Gamma is zeta, that is 18 degrees, and beta is 60 degrees. So ID1 is equal to, after substituting the value of gamma is 18 and beta is 60 and IS is 5 kilo amps, we are going to get the value of ID1 as 2.255 kilo amps. Now let us see another mode, that is ID is lying between ID1 and ID2. So in mode 1 only A bit and B bit we are seeing, okay, and C bit also is there. So three conditions we are assuming in mode 1. First one is ID is lying between 0 and ID1. Second is ID is lying between ID1 and ID2. Third is ID is lying between ID2 and ID3. So second one, that is ID is lying between ID1 and ID2. So when ID is ID2, beta is 90 and gamma is zeta plus 30. So ID2 is IS into cos gamma minus cos beta. So substitute all the values, we are going to get the value of ID2 as 3.346 kiloamps. Let us see the third mode of operation, that is C bit. ID is lying between ID2 and ID3. Now ID is become ID3 and beta is 90 plus zeta, that is 108. Gamma is zeta plus 30. Substitute all the values, ID3 value we are going to get as 4.891 kiloamps. Now let us see the first bit, that is your ID is 2500 amps. What is the extinction angle, overlap angle and DC voltage? So inverter is operating in mode 1B here. So here U equal to 60 minus zeta, that is 42 degrees, that is constant. ID dash by sine U by 2 whole square plus VD dash by cos U by 2 whole square is 1. ID dash is 2.5 by 10, that is 0.25. VD dash square is equal to 1 minus 0.25 by sine 21 degrees square, that is into cos square 21. So VD dash is 0.6689. VD is VD not VD. So substitute these values, we are going to get the value of VD as 63.88 kilovolt. Since VD dash is cos gamma minus ID, cos gamma is VD plus ID dash. So 0.6689 plus 0.25. This is VD dash value, and gamma is cos inverse of 0.9189. That is 23.2 degrees. Now let us see for second case, but that is ID equal to 4200 amps. Inverter is operating in mode C. ID dash is 0.42, or gamma is 48. So VD dash is cos gamma minus ID dash, cos 48 minus 0.42, that is 0.2491, and VD is VD dash into VD0, that is substitute these values, so 23.79 kilovolt. So to compute overlap angle, ID dash is half of cos gamma minus cos gamma plus U. Cos 48 plus U is there, that is cos 48 minus 2 ID dash. Cos 48 degrees minus 0.4, that is U is beta minus gamma 99.8 minus 48 degrees, that is 51.8 degrees. I hope the numericals are clear to everyone. Okay. Now let us see the characteristics of a 12 pulse converter. So there are two separate groups here, 6 pulse group and 6 pulse group. Both together will form a 12 pulse converter. So as long as the AC voltages at the converter bus remain in sinusoidal, the operation of one bridge is unaffected by the operation of other bridge connected in series. In this case, converter characteristics will be like this, as shown in the figure. With the assumption that the AC voltages at the converter bus will remain constant, and the region of rectifier operation can be divided into 5 modes. Mode 1, mode 2, mode 3, mode 4 and mode 5. At mode 1, 4 and 5 valve will conduct and U is lying between 0 and 30 degrees. Mode 2, 5 and 6 valve will conduct, U is lying between 30 and 60 degrees. Mode 3, 6 valve conduction, alpha is between 0 and 30 degrees and U is 60 degrees. At mode 4, 6 and 7 valve conduction will take place and U lies between 60 and 90 degrees. Mode 5, 7 and 8 valve will conduct and U lies between 90 and 120 degrees. Second mode is a continuation of first, and similarly fifth is a continuation of fourth. So 5 valve and 7 valve conduction modes are just points on the boundaries corresponding to their previous and following modes, and region corresponding to mode 3 will shrink to a point when alpha exceeds 30 degrees. So characteristics of inverter will be similar, except that a submode can exist for mode 1 or mode 2 depending on the value of margin angle which we are going to choose. Characteristics of this mode will be elliptical. The equivalent circuit of 12 pulse converter is the series combination of equivalent circuit for the two bridges. This is because the two bridges will be connected in series on the DC side and in parallel on the AC side. Current waveforms in the primary winding of star star and star delta connected transformer and the line current injected into the converter bus are shown. Okay, these are the characteristics for star star and star delta connected transformer. When no AC filters are provided and the source reactance is not zero, operation of either bridge is affected by the commutation process taking place in the other bridge. In this case, operation of the 12 pulse converter will be quite complex and there can be additional modes, that is 5 amp conduction and 6, 7, 8, 7 valve conduction. Also, there could be new mode of 5, 6, 7, 6 valve conduction instead of 6 valve conduction, depending upon the value of coupling factor K, which is defined as K equal to XS by XS plus XT. Okay, this is K equal to XS by XS plus XT. This is a coupling factor, it is K. And where XS is the source reactance and XT is the converter transformer leakage reactance. Here we have to note one point that interaction between adjacent bridges can be neglected if the converter bus voltages are sinusoidal, that is, when AC filters are provided. However, the presence of source reactance will result in the variation of the magnitude of the bus voltage unless voltage control is provided at the converter station. This can affect the shape of the converter characteristics. So, this is the characteristics of 12-pulse converter. Okay, I hope this is clear to everyone. 5 modes of operation will be there and we have seen the characteristics of 12-pulse. So today's class we have seen about the converter characteristics or non-commutated converter characteristics for rectifier and inverter operation. For rectifier there will be 3 modes, first mode, second mode and third mode. First mode, U is less than 60 degrees, it is called as 2 and 3 valve conduction mode. Second mode, U is equal to 60 degrees, it is called as 3 valve conduction mode, only for alpha less than 30 degrees. Third mode, U lies between 60 and 120 degrees. It is called as 3 and 4 valve conduction mode, that is alpha is greater than or equal to 30 degrees. Alpha greater than or equal to 30 degrees, mode 2 is bypassed, and mode 1 and mode 3 we are having the equation of voltage. Vd by Vd0 is cos alpha minus Id by 2Is, and Vd by Vd0 is root 3 cos alpha minus 30 degrees minus 3 Id by 2Is. Voltage and current characteristics will be linear with different slopes. For mode 2, U equal to 60 degrees, U is constant, so characteristics are elliptical and voltage is given by this value, okay? So, Vd dash and Id dash are the new terms which we got the equation, new equations. Boundary for rectifier operation is shown in the figure. This is converter Vd Id characteristics. X-axis we are taking Id by 2Is, Y-axis by Vd by Vd0 and capital ABCD are the various points which are plotted on the boundary. And for the coordinates of points A, B, C, D, and E on the boundary, and it is given in the tabular column A, B, C, D, E, and the value of alpha, U, and Id dash and Vd dash are shown in this tabular column. Then you have seen the inverter characteristics. Inverter characteristics will be similar to rectifier characteristics. However, operation as an inverter will require minimum commutation margin angle during which the voltage across the valve will be negative. So, operating region of inverter will be different from that of a rectifier. So, now there is a new term called as here, commutation margin angle, zeta, which is equal to extension angle, gamma, only for values of beta less than or equal to 60 degrees. Voltage across the valve has a positive 10 D because of sextering commutation. So, here, 3 ranges are there, first range, second range and third range. Okay, for first range, what we are telling here? That zeta equal to gamma and voltage across the valve has a positive 10 D. And for the second case, we are telling that zeta is less than gamma, and with increased overlap and consequently earlier ignition angle, the dent will encroach on the period in which the back voltage will be negative, and after the front of the dent becomes entirely negative, further advance of the dent will not decrease commutation margin further as seen in the third range. So there will be three ranges, first, second and third. So first range, beta is less than 60 degrees, zeta equal to gamma, and beta lies between 60 and 90 degrees, zeta is 60 minus u, gamma minus beta minus 60. Third range, beta is greater than 90 degrees and zeta is equal to gamma minus 30 degrees. First range, beta is less than or equal to 60 degrees. Second range, beta lies between 60 and 90 degrees. Third range, beta is greater than 90 degrees. So, for mode 1 and mode 2, we are going to see the equation for voltages and currents. This is the tabular column of showing boundary of inverter characteristics. Points A, B, C, D, E, F and values of gamma, U and ID dash and VDG dash are shown here. Then we have seen two numericals based on this topic. Then characteristics of 12 pulse converter we have seen. So as long as the AC voltage is at the converter bus will remain sinusoidal, operation of one bridge is unaffected by the operation of other bridge connected in series. So region of rectifier operation is divided into five modes. Mode 1, mode 2, mode 3, mode 4 and mode 5. Mode 1, U is lying between 0 and 30 degrees, 4 and 5 conduction. Mode 2, U is lying between 30 and 60 degrees, it is 5 and 6 valve conduction. Mode 3, U is equal to 60 degrees, alpha is lying between 0 and 30 degrees, it is 6 valve conduction. Mode 4, U is lying between 60 and 90 degrees, it is 6 and 7 valve conduction. Mode 5, U is lying between 90 and 120 degrees, it is 7 and 8 valve conduction. Second mode is a continuation of first, and similarly fifth is a continuation of fourth. Equivalent circuit of the 12 pulse converter is the series combination of equivalent circuit for the two bridges. This is because two bridges will be connected in series on the DC side and parallel on the AC side. Current waveforms in the primary winding of star star and star delta connected transformers and the line current injected into the converter are shown here. Here we are introducing a new term, coupling factor H, which is defined as XS by XS plus XT. XS is the source reactance, XT is the converter transformer leakage reactance. Interaction between adjacent bridges can be neglected if the converter bus voltages are sinusoidal. However, the presence of source reactance will result in the variation of magnitude of bus voltage, and this will affect the shape of the converter characteristics. Thank you, students, for watching the video. I hope this is clear to everyone. In the next slide, I am going to say about the detailed analysis of converters. So, assumptions of constant DC current and constant sinusoidal voltages at the AC bus will be relaxed, and analysis taken to account impedances in both AC and DC networks. So, there we are. I am going to say about the capacitor commutator converter. So, how it varies with the actual margin angle and current, the equivalent circuit of commutation, analysis of voltage source converter also we are going to see. Okay, the next class. Then by next class, the second unit will be finished, students. Okay, thank you for watching the video. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Thank you everyone for watching the video.